Hello students, so this is the last video regarding the temporal boom. So in our previous classes we have discussed about two videos. In the first part we have seen the squamous part of the temporal bone and the mastoid part of temporal bone, whereas in the second video we have seen the petrous part of temporal bone. And now in this last video I'm just going to show you the internal features of the petrous part of temporal bone and as well as the styloid process. So coming to the styloid process, as we all know that styloid process is an elongated bony projection which we can identify from the inferior border of the tympanic part of temporal bone. So here you can see the inferior border, it is extending deep and is going to split and covers the root of the styloid process. So this styloid process, it is giving attachment to some muscles. One is styloglossus, stylopharyngeus and stylohyoid muscle, and it is related to the posterior medial surface of the parotid gland. Whereas if you see the capsule of the parotid gland, that is fibrous capsule or false capsule, the deep part means the false capsule is going to thicken and extending from the styloid process to the angle of mandible to the gunion and forms stylomandibular ligament. So the thickening of the deep lamellae of the investing layer of deep cervical fascia, which forms the stylomandibular ligament, that which is extending from the styloid process to the gunion or angle of the mandible. Yes, coming to the internal features of the petrous part of temporal bone, internal features, so it is going to divide into two parts. One is lateral part over here, then medial part which is present inside. Okay, this is lateral part and inside part is the medial part. Now this is the right sided one, so I took another right side bone and I have just took a section to show you the medial part and the lateral part of the petrous part of temporal bone. So observe carefully. So I have opened the posterior part. So as this is a right sided one, so I took a section like this, so I have removed the anterior part. Here you can see the posterior part. Okay, so anterior part has been removed, so you can see entire this part is the posterior part. So what are the things you can identify in the medial part? What you can identify in the lateral part? What we can identify? So the medial part, which displays a bony medial wall, it is all the bony medial wall. You can identify clearly, it is the bony medial wall of tympanic cavity. We can identify an elevation over here. So this elevation is called as promontory. This elevation is called as promontory. So in the central part, we can identify this promontory. And for the basal turn of cochlea of internal ear, a reniform opening of fenestra vestibuli behind, and then fenestra vestibuli behind and above. Behind and above, we can identify fenestra vestibuli, the promontory, above the promontory. Okay, so a small rounded opening we can identify behind and below, called as fenestra cochlea. So here you can identify fenestra vestibuli, yes, promontory over here, then behind and above fenestra vestibuli, behind and below fenestra cochlea. Now these things we have seen in the medial wall. So medial wall, remember, promontory, fenestra vestibuli behind and above, fenestra cochlea behind and below. Then coming to the roof of this tympanic cavity, roof of the tympanic cavity is formed by tegmen tympani. And the floor is formed by the jugular fossa. In this colored individual skull, you can identify the jugular fossa over here. I'll try to show you here. Yes, so here you can see the jugular fossa. So the upper part of the jugular fossa is present at the lower part of bottom of the tympanic cavity. Okay. So in this, you can identify the jugular fossa here. So we have entered into this cavity. So here, from this, here you can identify the fenestra cochlea below, fenestra vestibular, vestibuli above. Okay. So that is about the roof. Then floor is formed by jugular fossa. What are other things which we can identify? So posterior part, from the posterior to this, exactly opposite to the fenestra vestibuli, we can identify a bony canal. In the upper part it is oblique, in the lower part it is vertical. There is a bony canal for the facial nerve called as facial canal. I am passing my probe in the stylomastoid foramen. So the lower part is vertical, upper part it is oblique. Okay, so that is the longest osseous canal, longest bony canal. Okay, then upper part of the bony tympanic cavity, upper posterior part, we can identify an opening. So this is, it opens into the mastoid antrum. So the floor of the antrum, it opens into the mastoid process. So this is, I am passing my probe in the tympanic cavity. Through the tympanic cavity, I am entering into this mastoid antrum. So the lower part, the floor of the antrum opens into the mastoid process. The lower part of anterior wall. So coming to the lower part of anterior wall, I will just try to show you in this uncolored skull. Yes, wait for a while, just bear with me. Lower part of the anterior wall, we can identify an L-shaped foramen for internal carotid artery. We can identify a foramen, it is for internal carotid artery. In another bone, I will try to show you. Yes, here you can identify L-shaped. So anterior wall, lower part of anterior wall, which we can identify an L-shaped groove, it is for internal carotid artery and the sympathetic plexus, sympathetic fibers which are surrounding the internal carotid artery. And then, so the anterior wall, it is having upper part and the lower part. Upper part for tensor tympani, lower part for sulcus tubae or auditory tube. So that are the features which we can identify at the medial part of the petrous part of temporal bone. Whereas at the lateral part of petrous part of temporal bone, what we can identify is, we can identify a sulcus called as tympanic sulcus. So here you can identify, here you can see the tympanic sulcus, which we can identify at the lateral end of the petrous part of temporal bone. So here we can identify anteroinferiorly, we can identify tympanic plate. Okay, and then squamous part above. And then tympanic sulcus, here you can identify the entire, this sulcus is called as tympanic sulcus. So medially, this tympanic sulcus, it is giving attachment to the tympanic membrane. So here you can identify a sharp margin. So this margin, which is giving attachment to the tympanic membrane. Okay, so these are the features which we can identify at the interior of the petrous part of temporal bone. Coming to the ossification, the squamous part, entire this squamous part is ossified in membrane from a single center close to the roots of zygomatic process in the second month of intrauterine life. Petromastoid part is ossified in the cartilage from multiple centers, as many as 14 multiple centers. Okay, around otic capsule in the fifth month of fetal life. Whereas the tympanic part, is ossified in membrane from the tympanic ring during the third fetal month. The ring grows anterior inferior to form tympanic plate. Sometimes the defective spread of ossification produces the hiatus of Huschke, which is closed in the recent state of fibrous membrane. Then the styloid process is developed from the cartilage of second branchial arch and is ossified from two centers, upper or tympanohyoid part before birth and lower part, lower or stylohyoid part after birth. The fusion of the above mentioned four components takes place during the first postnatal year. In some cases, the tympanohyoid or stylohyoid parts of the steroid process may not fuse. So this is about the ossification centers of all the parts: squamous, mastoid part, styloid part, and the petrous part. Thank you.